Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will learn about variables in shell scripting. So what is variable? Variable is a memory location which is used to store some value. And that value can be a number, it can be a string or text, it can be a file, or it can be any form of data. So the next thing is how to define a variable. To define a variable, we simply need to write the name of the variable. In the previous video, I have explained what are the different rules of defining a variable. You can go through that video to understand it better. So I have taken this variable x in which I have stored a value 10. Similarly, here this is an integer value. Similarly, in variable y, I have stored a float value. Here in z, we have stored a letter, and here we have stored a collection of letters. Both are strings, but here it has only one word, and it is composed of three words, right? And it is enclosed in single quotes, or even you can enclose it in double quotes. So then you can see here that if you talk about other programming languages such as C, C++, and Java, there you need to define the data type. But in case of shell scripting, here, also in Python also, we don't have to explicitly mention the data type of the variable, right? So here, shell script automatically determines the data type used for the variable value. Fine. Now, this was about defining variable. Now, how to access the values? To access the value, we have to use the command echo, in which we will be using this dollar symbol. So this dollar symbol is used before the variable name. So variables referred are using dollar symbol. So echo space dollar symbol, and then we will write the name of the variable. And then only it is going to give you the value of the variable. If you don't write this, it is simply going to display X. If you don't follow dollar symbol before the variable name, it will simply print X. But when you display, when you put this dollar symbol, it is going to fetch the value. So here it will be returning 10. Similarly, here it will be returning 7.3, and then it will be printing nature, and here it will be giving you the output as life is beautiful. So these are the two ways of defining the variable and accessing the values stored in the variable, right? Now, so in the previous case, we already gave the variable value. We gave a value to the variable, right? So whenever you will run the program or run the shell script, and if you have stored, given some value to the variable, it is always going to display this value. But what if you want to give the value to the variable at the runtime? In that case, we will be having a command that is read. So how it is going to function, let's see. So first you are going to use this echo command, in which you have displayed a message that enter the number. So you will be using this read command. And after that, you are going to write the name of the variable, that is X. And as I have told you, when you are given some value, so it can be anything. It can be 10, 20, 30. So you can change the value again and again. And when you try to fetch the value, as I have told you earlier in the previous concept, that the variable name has to be prefixed by this dollar symbol. So it is then going to give you the value which is being stored in this variable. Now, majorly, we have two types of variables in shell script. First is your user-defined variables, and these are defined by the users. And you can hear, like we have done the previous example also, you can simply give some value to a variable and you can display its result. So whatever value you will be giving, it will be giving you the output accordingly. The second type of variable is environment variables, and they are also called as system defined variables. And because they are defined by the OS, that is why they are also called as system defined variables or environment variables. Here, the variables are not defined by the user, but they are already present in the Linux, right, by default. So if you write, so some of them are like path and user, we have OS type, we have bash version. So many environment variables are there. So I have mentioned only two. So simply you have to write echo space, then again, as you can see, this dollar symbol is must. Here also you have used this dollar symbol, and here also you are using the dollar symbol. So whether it is user defined variable or it is environment variable, you have to use the dollar symbol before the variable name. So it is going to define the path of the shell, and it is going to tell the who is the current user login, right? So in the next coming lectures, and also one more important point is both of them are case sensitive. So here, if you are storing something in small x, like lowercase x, and if you're storing something in uppercase x, let's say I store 100. So when you will try to display the value of this, the small x will give you 14 and the uppercase will give you 100. So similarly, in environment variables, the variable shell variable, environment shell variables are always in capital. This thing you have to be very much cautious about, and otherwise both of them are case sensitive. So shell scripting is case sensitive, so be careful about it. So in the coming lecture, I will be uploading a individual video for user defined variable and a different video for environment variables. So there, in that videos, we will be able to understand the concept in detail. So till then, stay tuned to my channel. Thank you so much.